It's absolutely mind-boggling. Hey guys, Chris, Jeremy, Jeshwant, and Cheryl here from the Harmony Turbines team. Guys, we've done it. We have literally finally cracked the biggest issue that we've been stuck on for the better part of 2 years. We've been trying to create our own charge controller for the front end to protect the battery system and properly charge our battery banks, whether they're a 48 volt or a 36 or a 96 volt battery bank, whatever we have, we've been working on our own charge controller to do that. But in the end, we actually don't need a charge controller. That's actually been unnecessary. Now I'm gonna say that again, that has been unnecessary.
Wait, what?
The whole purpose of a charge controller is to keep your batteries safe and not over voltage them, not put them into a state where you're getting too much voltage and cooking your batteries. Well, guess what guys, our furling system, hello, our patented furling system does that for us guys. It chops off the upper end of our production and brings it down to a manageable level so we can control the voltage going into the batteries with our furling system. We actually don't need a charge controller in this system, and we just on Friday finally hooked it up in this crazy new way to test it, and it works flawlessly.
Well, whoop-dee-doo. You just gave the whole secret away. Can't anyone just take their charge controller off of their system?
And have some and amazing, no. So guys, our turbine operates in a very specific RPM range, a much smaller RPM range than your traditional propeller turbines. Our simplified axial flux generator has been built from the ground up to operate in a specific voltage and amperage range for our battery bank, which in this case is 48 volts. If we had someone with a 96 volt battery bank, we would make them a different generator. So everything is tuned to work together. Our turbine scoops work with our generator, work with the battery voltage range of the battery bank, and then on top of all of that sits our furling system that governs and keeps tabs on where we're at with the voltage ranges to make sure that we don't cook the batteries. So in the end, all of these pieces, all four of those things work together to make sure that you have a cohesive functioning system that operates flawlessly together for you. Another company out there trying to do that would have disastrous results. Okay. End of story. We're gonna demonstrate something right here that is literally mind-boggling how simple this system is. And it's crazy that it's been in front of us this whole time. It's such an unconventional way to do it. We never really thought about hooking the system up this way. So we're gonna show you our voltage of the battery bank is here. Here's the amperage that will be coming from the generator. And as Jeremy spins it, he'll take his hand off here and there to show you that it's basically as simple as can be for the turbine to start up in a no wind situation, going to a very low wind situation. And then as he gets faster and faster, we'll actually start pushing amperage. There we go. We're pushing amperage into the batteries. So right now we are pushing that amperage at 48 volts into the batteries. We're overcoming the voltage of the batteries. That's why you're seeing that number on the left go up when we're putting power into it. So there we are. So 49.03, 05, 06. That's because we are charging the batteries right now directly with our current that we're making. And then if you take your hand off, Jeremy, you saw how very quickly we went from a power generation state, and here we go, I'm letting go. It's a very, very simple solution. We're not sitting there overtaxing. The turbine is not gonna like come to a dead stop when we're putting power into it. It's literally, it's putting a half an amp of power into it, and he's not even breaking a sweat. He's just very lazily doing this. So the big problem with the charge controllers that we've been seeing all through the last 2 years of working on this is as soon as those charge controllers would engage, when it would say, we're at the voltage I want, you would get a very, very sudden, abrupt, like almost stop on the shaft. You're spinning it, it's nice and easy, and then it would go, and it would be like, and then you'd feel it going, it would literally kill anything that was happening on the turbine.
Right. As soon as we crossed that threshold where we could draw power off, the system would say, I want all the power I can get.
Right. Yeah.
And it would put a resistive load on our generator such that it would actually stop the turbine.
Yep. So that was a nightmare because we're trying to solve that soft start. That whole process with the charge controller was a nightmare. I'm spinning this with two fingers right now, guys, and actually charging the batteries. I am charging the batteries at 48 volts and putting a half an amp into it. It's hard to hang on to it with two fingers. But that's crazy. Guys, we've never, ever, ever, ever had anything even close to this with an electronic solution. And this is quite literally an analog solution. The batteries themselves are the biggest filter you could ever want. They're taking straight rectified DC power and putting it in. So this is huge, guys, because what this means is we can take power off of our system on the back end, and he doesn't feel any change on the front end at all. So this is the entire use case right here in front of you. Battery bank, charge capability, filtering, everything is being done by this incredibly simple system. We have never before had such a simple time, both on the soft start as the turbine begins to push power into the batteries, and then in high mode, I don't know if you wanna go crazy with it, but the other day I got up to 4.5 amps that I was pushing into it. Now Jeremy's not working real hard, but he's pushing like close to 3 amps into it there. I got, just by spinning it by hand like a maniac, up to 4.5 amps of power that we were pushing into the battery bank. Guys, this is it. This is our beta program now begins today. We literally have the capability to go into beta with this one simple realization that we don't need the front end charge controller. On the upper end, as soon as we monitor that the voltage is getting above, say, in a 48 volt bank, if we reached 58 volts, we would begin to furl in to control our power going into the battery bank so that we didn't fry the batteries. And if the voltage continues creeping beyond what we want, we would just further furl in to control that. So we have a governor on the top end doing exactly what a charge controller does, but in a different way. And that's always been here from the beginning here at Harmony Turbines. We've had our furling system working perfectly for years, and we never thought about it being the control mechanism for the top end on the batteries to keep them safe. So the inverter on the back end of the customer, where are we getting smoking? The light's so hot. Just pull that away, Jeshwant. Yeah, there we go. The light was so hot, it was actually starting to cook the wires a little bit. So guys, we're pulling 500 watts off of our battery bank right now. And even while it's running, just like in your home, when your battery bank is in use and you're running your home, he is charging simultaneously into the battery bank, no problem at all. And it's easy as pie. I mean, it's not hard at all. So we're gonna do another video in a little bit, and we're gonna show you the upper end of what this generator can do. But guys, we got up to 3 kilowatts that we were making with our generator the other day. 3 kilowatts with our generator. Now, obviously, out in the real world, we're not expecting to get anywhere close to 3 kilowatts, but the generator can do 3 kilowatts, and that's pretty freaking insane. So we've got the generator locked down, we've got our charging system, we've got the upper end battery protection now, and all of it with soft start, where we're not impacting and hitting that turbine with such a resistance that it stops spinning. This is literally gonna be able to go up on the roof and spin effortlessly in the wind. So it's huge. This is huge. Guys, this is the beginning of our beta program right here. You're seeing it for the first, literally the first day after we realized that we had this, we're able to take it and run with it now. So if you have not invested in the company, you may want to consider doing it now, because this is groundbreaking. This is huge. This is the thing we've finally been waiting to crack, and it's done. We've got it. We have every single piece now that we need to go into beta. So we're going to put the first unit up on the roof and get that installed. We'll do testing. Really, all we're going to be dialing in at that point is the number of turns on the coils and the epoxy that we're using to kind of dial that in so that we have a good mix between the power production we need and the longevity and the durability of the epoxy to hold up. But the generator is, everything about it is working perfectly. It's, at this point, it's just a matter of getting into our beta customers with these installations now. So whatever our customers have on the back end, the battery banks are going to be installed inside of a protected area. So any electronics and all that will be in the protected area, and nothing outside except the turbine and like 3 wires coming back to the battery bank. So that's it, guys. This is amazing stuff. This is crazy. that it was such a simple solution. It's been in front of us this whole time and we just never thought of it this way. We've talked to three electronics engineers about this now, and in each case, it was kind of like, wow, that's an unconventional way to think about it and do it. But yeah, there's no really big holes to poke in this process, because with the furling knocking down the upper end production, we can keep those batteries safe, where others out there can't do that. They can't claim that. They can't have the ability to keep their system safe. We can, and we can maintain that upper end power protection for our batteries with our simple furling system built right in. So guys, this was a big week and a lot of weight is kind of off our shoulders here with seeing that we got to this point. So if you want to invest, if you love what we're doing, if you love the raw research and development, everything that we're doing here, we're showing it to you guys. This is it. This is where it's all at. And hopefully you agree, this is some really, really exciting stuff. So if you want to get in on what we're doing here, now's your chance. Our funding round is opened. And this is huge. We, Harmony Turbines, is officially moving into our beta program now, guys. Thank you to everyone who's been with us, following with us, being here as an investor, as a follower, as a supporter, Patreon subscribers, YouTube followers, all of you. You have made this, the whole thing has become possible because of your belief in us, and then in turn, our hard work and perseverance to make this work. You know how they say, failure is not an option. That is definitely the motto here at Harmony Turbines. We have been pushing and pushing and pushing to get this to the state where it's at. We hope you agree. This is a major milestone. Our beta program is now officially open. We are going to start moving customers into beta and go from there, guys. Thank you so very much. Take care. Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.